All right. Welcome back, guys, to our channel. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad,
Rod Sr.
And we are Bridging the Gap. Yes, sir. So if you've been on this Kanye journey with us, we welcome you back. If this is your first time seeing one of our videos, then thanks for being here. If you like our reaction videos, please leave a big old thumbs up and drop a comment in the comment section. Let us know what we should listen to next, as well as turn your notification bells on so you can be notified every time we drop a new video. Without further ado, we're going to go ahead and just keep the Kanye train rolling. We're going to finish up our series. This is the first three albums, the college series from Kanye West. This last one is called Graduation. You ready for Graduation, Dad?
Yes. I hope it's good as it is as good as the first two.
Yeah, I feel like you enjoyed the first couple albums quite a bit. Yeah. So yeah, we won't waste too much time. Graduation was released in 2007 on September 11th, 2007. So I believe that was 2 years after Late Registration. And yeah, I mean, he kind of did the same thing as far as like getting some of the like really popular people at the time on this record to collab with him. He produced most of the beats, but he did have some more help as far as production. I feel like the first album was pretty much all Kanye, and then the second album was Kanye and John Bryan. Quite a bit with the production, and this one we're gonna see more collaborative producing on this album.
Okay.
So yeah, it was a really popular album. He had a really dope tour that went along with this album. If I remember correctly, it was the Glow in the Dark tour, and that was like one of the first big concerts I've ever gone to. It was amazing. It was such a cool live production. It was just really dope. So, yeah, we'll just get right into it. The first track here is called Good Morning. And I love that you spoke about on the last album, Heard Him Say, when it came in, you were like, oh, this is like a great song you put on right in the morning time or whatever. So everybody was like, oh, wait till he hears Good Morning.
Is that right?
Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, we'll get right into it. Graduation starts off with Good Morning. And this is produced by Kanye West.
All right.
And here's the intro. Here we go.
Good morning. Good morning. Wake up, Mr. West, Mr. West, Mr. Fresh, Mr. By himself, he's so impressed. I mean, damn, did you even see the test? You got D's, motherfucking D's, Rosie Perez, and yes, better pass.
Any of that be class,
looking at every ass, cheating on every test. I guess this is my dissertation. Homie, this shit is basic. Welcome to graduation. Good morning.
We're still living, get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's it, you're still living. Get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down.
Every time that we hit them, good morning.
Hustlers, that's if you're still living. Get on down. Get on down.
All right, that is the intro track, Good Morning, to Graduation. What did you think about that one, Dad?
That was pretty nice entry song, you know, intro song. I liked it when that last little chorus, when he started added that hustlers line.
Kind of round hustlers, yeah. As if you're still living.
That was a nice touch on that song. But for some reason, when he first started rapping, man, I could have swore. I said, damn, he kind of sounded like Eminem.
Yeah, that's interesting.
You know, he said that like little hit an Eminem. His voice sounded like Eminem's.
Yeah.
But he wasn't going as fast as Eminem.
Yeah, yeah.
So you could say, well, maybe, I don't know. I just thought maybe he slipped him in there on a, you know. But then I started listening to it, and I'm like, okay, that's him. That's Kanye. Yeah. So anyway.
Well, that probably means that you just really want to hear some more Eminem.
I wouldn't mind.
Okay, cool, cool. New, more Eminem coming soon. That, right. The subscribers would really, really love that. God, they do the Eminem show.
The Eminem show. Yeah, oh, is that a good one?
Yeah, that's the one I said was corny.
Yeah. Oh, and then you got bad for
they
it.
Just yeah. For, ever since then, I've we keep getting comments. we'll do that one for sure. We'll get your opinion on it. Right. But yeah, at the end, he actually was. That's a sample that Jay-Z line, "Hustlers Gather Around, if you're still living, get on down." Mm-hmm. That's a Jay-Z sample from, I believe, The Blueprint, and Kanye produced a lot on The Blueprint. So I thought that is like a popular Jay-Z line, and for him to like sample it and chop it up and put it in that little bridge was pretty cool.
Right.
I'm glad you noticed that. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. So we'll go ahead and roll right into track number two. This one is titled Champion.
What is this album cover, man? This looks like
check it out.
Little okay, so he's getting, looks like he's getting either launching off or getting shot out of some kind of like maybe a cannon or so. I don't know what the hell that is,
man. Yeah.
Yeah, was he? He must have been really high when they somebody was when they created that image.
Yeah, well, the image on the album cover is actually done by like this really popular Japanese artist.
Oh, okay.
But it was kind of carrying on with the theme of the bear. The bear was like on the last two album covers as well.
Japanese artists. Okay, now I can see the influence on, you know. The, uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah. All right. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. All right. Yeah, so we'll go ahead and roll right into track number two. This is called Champion. This is produced by Brian Miller and Kanye West. Champion. Here we go.
All right.
Yes, I did. So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. Mm-hmm. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you are a champion? You don't see just how wild the crowd is. You don't see just how fly my style is. I don't see why I need a stylist when I shot so much I can speak Italian. I don't know, I just want it better for my kids. And I ain't saying we was from the projects, but every time I want to lay away or deposit, my dad would say, when you see clothes, close your eyelids. We was sort of like Will Smith and his son in the movie. I ain't talking about the rich one. Visible. Now they know they invincible. Hey, hey, hey.
This is the story of the champion. Oh. Oh, I can break that up a little bit. Tell me what it takes to be number one. Tell me what it takes to be number one. This is the story of a champion. Yeah. Runners in the market, they pop the gun. Stand up, stand up. Here he comes. Tell me what it takes to be number one. Tell me what it takes to be number one. Did you realize? Nah, he got me going on that one there. That was nice. That was nice.
Yes, I did. So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something, show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. Mm-hmm. That's that shit. So if you gon' do it just like shit. This. Like
All right, that.
Oh man, I wanted it to keep going a little bit more. I like he said, "This is shit." Yeah.
All right, so that is track number two, Champion. What did you think about that one, Dad?
That was a good song. And then that when they broke into that little chorus thing, they was going on. Oh, that really hooked me in. Mm-hmm. It was like, yeah, it started rocking to me now.
All right, cool. So we're feeling Champion.
Champion.
All right, we'll go ahead and move into track number three. This track is called Stronger, and I would find it, I feel like you've had to heard this song.
Champion had a lot of good messages in there, too.
Oh, yeah.
He's always like, he's like a philosopher.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, he's always got some good thoughts to share. Yeah, Stronger is produced by Kanye West, Mike Dean, and Timbaland.
Timbaland.
Uh-huh. And yeah, this song is absolutely gigantic. It's samples Daft Punk. Mm. Yeah, you've had to heard this song.
You think so?
Yeah. For all right. Sure.
All
right. All right, track number three, Stronger.
Make it, do it, makes us honor, better, faster, stronger. Now, that don't kill me, can only make us stronger.
Never heard this?
I need you to hurry up, man.
Oh, I gotta listen a little bit.
Okay.
I know I got to be right, man, cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man, that's how long I've been on ya.
Nope.
What?
Let's get lost. Sorry. I'm gonna kick them off tonight. Play secretary on the ball tonight. And you don't give a fuck what they all say, right? Awesome, the Christian and Christian Dior. Damn, they don't make them like this anymore. I ask, cause I'm not sure. Do anybody make real shit anymore? Bow in the presence of greatness. Cause right now, that has forsaken us. You should be honored by my lateness. That I would even show up to this fake shit. So go ahead, go nuts, go ape shit. Especially in my pastel on my page shit. Act like you can't tell who made this new gospel. Homie, take six and take this.
Hey, take this. New gospel, take six. I'm thinking, who can make this man?
All right, I hear you, Kanye.
I can't much longer. I know I got to be right now. Cause I can't get much stronger. That's how long I've been on ya. I'm tripping this drink, got me saying a lot. But I know that God put you in front of me. So how the hell could you front on me? It's 1,000 yous, it's only one of me. I'm tripping, I'm caught up in a moment, right? Cause it's Louis Vuitton dine night. So we gon' do everything the kind like. Heard they do anything for a Klondike. Well, I'll do anything for a Blondike. And she'll do anything for the limelight. And we'll do anything when the time's right. Baby, you're making it.
Boy, can rap. Can rap. Straight up legit. Yeah.
I know I got to be right now. Cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya.
All right, that is track number three, I think. Track number three, Stronger off Graduation. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I like that one. Every time I hear a song, it's always like just one line in there that I remember about that song.
Yeah.
And the one the line in this song that I remember is he said something to the effect that it's a whole lot of yous, but only one of me.
Yeah.
He's talking to this girl. He's talking to this lady, right?
Yeah.
And he said, it's a whole lot of yous,
yeah,
but there's only one of me. Yeah. And I was like, he just be like, he knows how to make good music, that's for sure.
Uh-huh.
And I liked the way the song went. And then at the end, when I thought it was over, he just started going on with it, just jamming with it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I like that.
Yeah, I love that you pointed out that line. That's probably one of the more popular lines from that rap. Yeah, for sure.
Shit.
Yeah, everybody likes that line. Especially right now, too, because like Kanye's dating this new girl.
Right.
She kind of looks just like Kim Kardashian. So people have put in the meme like it's 1,000 views. It's only one of me.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Yeah.
Is he dressing her too?
Yeah, probably. She looks pretty Kanye'd out.
Kanye'd out. Okay.
Yeah, but also, what'd you think about, I guess, like, the sample, the Daft Punk, kind of like the electronic music?
Yeah.
What'd you think about that?
I like that. Kind of remind me of, you know, when they was doing the, when Roger Troutman and all those guys was playing around with stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's a different kind of instrument or whatever they was using, but different sound, but it still reminded me of them, the way those artists sampled and used different sounds and stuff to add into their songs. So that was a nice touch. Kanye is like, he uses a little bit of everything, and he could just, to me, he takes sometimes the little bittiest things and putting it on a song and it make the song just like pop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It makes it, you're like, oh yeah, that's why that song is good.
Mm-hmm.
Just by that little addition of this and that.
For sure.
You know, man. All right. Kanye.
He's pretty good, huh?
Yeah. I like it. I like this one. This whole series so far has been enjoyable.
Excellent. Cool. So we will go ahead and get into track number 4. This is titled I Wonder. I think this is one of my personal favorites off of this album. I just really like the sample and the beat and everything. This one's produced by Kanye West, and this is track number 4, I Wonder. Here we go.
Find your dreams come true, and I wonder if you know.
Oh, no.
What it means, what it means. And I wonder if you know what it means, what it means. And I wonder if you know what it means. Tuition is will you have back in the car, drive back to the crib, run back to their arms, the smoke screens, the chokes and the screams. You ever wonder what it all really mean? I wonder if you know what it means, what it means. Without a spouse, something in your blouse got me feeling so aroused. What you about? On that independent shit. Trade it all for a husband and some kids. You ever wonder what it all really means? You wonder if you ever find your dreams.
Wow.
That is I Wonder, track number 4 off of Graduation. What'd you think about that one?
That was tight. It was tight. I like that song. And then just like he fooled me the last time, I thought the song was over with. And then he comes back and adds even more to it, another layer. And that ending, the way he did that was sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, I love that. And then just one thing that I think kind of distinguishes Graduation from his other previous albums. I'm just reading this little excerpt here on Genius. So he had gone on tour with U2, and he was opening up for them, apparently, on the Vertigo tour. Mm-hmm. And after witnessing the praise that they received when opening concerts, he sought to achieve stadium status through anthemic music. And I definitely think that this album is full of, like, stadium-sounding songs, like, you know, like songs that you perform in front of large crowds, yep, of people, and it's exactly made with that in mind. Mm-hmm. And the way that the songs sound and just like the way he produced it all and stuff, I think that's really where he was at,
yeah,
on this album. So
yeah, that was an amazing song. Really, it was.
Yeah, I like that one a lot. All right, we'll go ahead and move into the next track, which is track number 5. This is titled Good Life, featuring T-Pain. And produced by Mike Dean, DJ Toomp, and Kanye West. You know,
I heard some T-Pain somewhere on somebody's album, I believe, didn't we? Trying to think.
I don't think we've heard T-Pain on anything. But
really,
have you heard of T-Pain?
That's the other thing. Then I probably heard of him then.
Yeah. So T-Pain came along around this time, and he was super, super popular. He used auto-tune quite a bit. He was like one of the artists at this time that made auto-tune extremely popular. It changed the whole like rap game and R&B game at this time, because everybody and their mama just started using auto-tune, but nobody could do it quite like T-Pain.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. T-Pain was the man. So yeah, Good Life. This was another very big single off of this album. It samples PYT by Michael Jackson.
Oh, okay.
This is a cool joint right here. Good Life. Here we go.
Like we always do with this time, I go for mine, I get to shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky. LD, won't even get pulled over in they new V. The good life, hey, hey, hey. Welcome to the good life. We'll be like the girls who ain't on TV, cause they got
more than the models.
The good life, so keep it coming with the bottles, so she feel booze like she bombed at Apollo. The good life, it feel like Houston, it feel like Philly, it feel like DC, it feel like VA or the Bay or yay.
Welcome to the good life.
Homie, tell me what's good. Why I only got a problem when you in the hood?
Welcome to the good life.
I'm in the hood. The only thing I wish
a nigga would.
Welcome to the good life.
Nigga would.
But I don't think he should.
Welcome to the good life.
50 told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up.
Ah, that's what 50 told him.
He told the truth.
Brain with it, as she said, I never seen snakes on a plane. Whether you broke or rich, you gotta get this. Having money's not everything, that having it is. I was splurging on trips, but when I get my car back activated, I'm back to Vegas. Cause I always had a passion for flashing. Before I had it, I closed my eyes and imagined the good life.
Better than the life I lived when I thought that I was gonna go crazy. And now my grandmama ain't the only girl calling me baby. If you feeling me now, then put your hands up in the sky and let me hear you say, hey, 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 I'm good.
All right, that is Good Life featuring T-Pain. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I like the rhythm, the flow of that song. It was good. I like the message, of course, and everything about that song I liked. It was a good song. I haven't heard a bad song so far.
Yeah.
Yeah.
cool. So yeah, Good Life was another really big single off of this album. So Stronger was really big, and then Good Life was a really big single that was like 3 times platinum or something like that.
I just like that one hook in there, and I'm gonna remember that one now. When 50 told him, said, "It's gonna switch your style up. The haters are gonna hate you, but watch the money pile up." Yeah. I was like, "Yeah, he told him truth right there."
Yeah, for sure. Cool. So we'll go ahead and roll into the next track. This one is produced by DJ Toomp and Kanye West. This is called "Can't Tell Me Nothing."
Can't tell me nothing. All right.
And this is one of them ones. This is another single off of this album. This is featuring Young Jeezy. I feel like we definitely got to listen to some Young Jeezy at some point. But pretty much Kanye just took Young Jeezy's ad-libs and just kind of like chopped them up over this beat, which is fire. Because Young Jeezy has such good ad-libs and they're like really recognizable. So it's just such a... just another fly thing that Kanye would do. Like, instead of like getting the art, like he just took his ad libs and made the song that much cooler. So, all right. So, nice. This is called "Can't Tell Me Nothing." I feel like you might have heard this in passing or something, but maybe not. This isn't as big as the other singles, but this one was still a big single. Mm-hmm. All right, "Can't Tell Me Nothing." Here we go.
La. Wait till I get my money right.
Huh. Oh,
I had a dream I could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I spent that on a necklace. Oh, I told God I'll be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act reckless. To whom much is given, much is tested. Get arrested, guess until he get the message. Oh, I feel the pressure under more scrutiny. And what I do, act more stupidly. I ain't go to hell, man. I guess the money should have changed them. I guess I should have forgot where I came from. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Let up the suicide doors. This is my life, homie. You decide yours. I know that Jesus died for us. But I couldn't tell you who the side was. So I parallel double park that motherfucker sideways. Old folks talking about back in my day. But if magic made it.
Whoa.
They say I talk with so much emphasis. Ooh, they so sensitive. Don't ever fix your lips like collagen. To say something where you gon' end up apologizing.
Wow.
Let me know if it's a problem then. Alright, man, hollering in. La, 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 la. Wait till I get my money right. La, 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 la. Then you can't tell me nothing right. The nose, how he stay faithful in a room full of hoes. Must be the pharaohs, he in tune with his soul. So when he buried in a tomb full of gold. Treasure, what's your pleasure? Life is a, you saying something? You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing.
Like that.
Tell me nothing, right?
Why don't
we too late? I'm serious, nigga. I got money.
Woo!
I'm serious, he flexing.
All right, that is track number 5. Can't Tell Me Nothing. What did you think about that one, Dad?
On this song right here, this reminded me, I don't know if it had anything to do with it, but it went. So far, what I've been learning about Kanye, it took me back to the special that he had.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like during the time when he was making beats for everybody, and he was like, making beats for people that was making way more money than him.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, they was kind of playing him like, you know, treating him like a little errand boy, so to speak. You know, give me my beats and just go on about your business.
Yeah.
But then in the back of his mind, he's tripping off of them because he's like, I rap better than you. Is right. What he's thinking in his mind. You know what I mean? And he's like, wait until I get my money right.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then he just set out and did a plan. You know, he had a plan. He had it all in his mind. Mm-hmm. It was already planned out. And then he got his money right. And now he's talking about, y'all can't tell me nothing.
Yeah.
Y'all can't tell me nothing. And I'm just like, dude, I know they had to feel good.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean?
For sure.
So anyway, yeah. That's what that kind of reminded me of, that song right there. And there was good lyrics in it. Mm-hmm. And I liked the touches, the, oh,
yeah.
You know, that, yeah. I liked all of that. Man, it was a nice song. That's yeah. a good song.
Yeah, I love that song. That's like up there for me as far as like Kanye West songs. That's mm-hmm. like, it's like, it's pretty up there. I really like that song a lot. Yeah. And it's, yeah, it's just like one of those, like, man, can't tell me nothing. Like, when you put that song on,
yeah.
like, you really can't tell me nothing.
Nothing.
Like,
that's right. That's right. That's the way, like, it made me feel, too.
You driving in your car, like, watch out, man.
Right, right.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, that's good.
He
that's
definitely good. Brought that feeling with that one. Okay, cool. So we'll go ahead and roll into track number 7. Freaking Nats.
I know.
Driving us crazy. We'll go ahead and roll it to track number 7. This one's called Barry Bonds. This Barry one is Bond. Featuring Lil Wayne and
Lil Wayne.
Produced by Knots and Kanye West. So, yeah, this is the first time
okay.
that we're going to hear from Lil Wayne on any of the albums that we've listened to. So, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So, this is going to be your intro to Lil Wayne.
I've been wanting to hear his rapping.
Yeah, Lil Wayne's the man. I love Lil Wayne. Yeah, so they just kind of talk their shit on this one. This
well,
is
you know what? To me, I mean, Lil Wayne is one of those really intellectual rappers too. Like Kanye is, I think he's really super intelligent,
mm-hmm.
and I think Lil Wayne is their intellect is way up there above the rest. You know, as far as intellect is concerned.
Yeah.
So that this would be interesting. I would love to see just a one-on-one conversation between Kanye and
Lil Wayne, I'd love to be a fly on the wall for a studio session with those two, for right. sure. All right, this one's called Barry Bonds. Here we go.
All right.
It's what y'all been waiting for, ain't it? What people pay paper for, damn it. They can't stand it. They want something new. So let's get reacquainted. Became the hood favorite. I can't even explain it. I surprised myself too. Life of a don. Lights keep glowing. Coming in the club with that fresh shit on. With something crazy on my arm. And here's another hit, Barry Bonds. We outta here, baby. We outta here, baby. We outta here, baby. Dude, fresh off the plane, konnichiwa. Bitches turn around another plane. My passport on pivot. Asked for it, I did it. That asshole done did it. Talked it, then he lived it. Spit it, then he shit it. I don't need right tears. I might bounce ideas, but only I could come up with some shit like this. I done played the underdog my whole career. Uh-huh. I've been a very good sport, haven't I, this year?
They
say going crazy, and we seen this before. But I'm doing pretty good as far as geniuses go.
Ooh.
And I'm doing pretty hood in my pink polo. Nigga, please, how you gonna say I ain't no low head? Cause my Dior got me mow my dough head. I'm insulted. You should go ahead and bow so hard till your knees hit your forehead. And the flow just hit cold red. Top 5 MCs, you ain't gotta remind me. Top 5 MCs, you gotta rewind me. I'm high up on the line, you could get behind me. But my head's so big, you can't sit behind me.
Ain't that
light
the truth?
From the dawn, lights keep blowing. Coming
he
in
know
the
himself,
club
don't he?
Fresh shit on with something crazy on my arm. And here's another hit, Barry Bonds.
Yeah, we out of here, baby. I'm so fucking good, like I'm sleeping with Megan. I'm all about the Franklins, Lincolns, and Reagans. Whenever they make them, I shall hate them. Oops, I meant have them. I'm so crazy, but if you play crazy, you be sleeping with daisies. I'm such a havoc. Oops, I meant havoc. And my drink's still pinker than the Easter rabbit. And I'm still cold like Keisha's family. Stove on my waist turned beef to baddies. And I ate it cause I'm so addict. And I don't front and I don't go backwards. And I don't practice and I don't lack shit. And you can get Barry, suck my back, bitch. We outta here, baby.
All right, that was Barry Bonds featuring Lil Wayne. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, the music production on that was crazy. And at first, when it first started out, I was like, okay, it took me a minute to get in the flow of this one. It was like, you know, off to me. Yeah. It sounded like it was kind of off at first. Mm-hmm. But then when they start coming in and they start rapping and you start listening to what they're saying, mm-hmm. you be like, oh, damn. That was good. That was a good one, too. So, Lil Wayne.
Yeah.
First time hearing him.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'd like to hear some more of him.
Okay.
Yeah, I would. I would like to hear some more of Lil Wayne because I've been hearing, you know, I remember you talking, you was big on Lil Wayne too. So, he did a really nice job on here. And I like the, just that, both of them got that quick wit kind of, I don't know what it is, man. It's like, but it's always profound, like, knowledge they be dropping on, mm-hmm. you know. And some of it be street, some of it be, you know, good stuff. And Kanye's always mentioning Jesus in his albums. I noticed that in everything he talks, he references God. Just like some of the rappers, they always rap referencing their AKs. This is what he emphasizes. You know, he references quite often in his music.
Yeah.
So like I said, I would love to hear Lil Wayne, and not even in the studio. Just like
just having them talking kicking, to
yeah,
each other.
Yeah, just talking to each other. I would love to hear that conversation.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
Interesting. Yeah.
Yeah. I like this song. I feel like Lil Wayne, he did his thing on here, but this ain't like
the real
he did his thing. It was cool, but like,
well, that's fresh on my ear because that's my first time hearing him, but I'm pretty sure there's more to Lil Wayne than that little bit he got to do, you know?
For sure.
Yeah. Barry Bonds, what's the deal with their thing with Barry Bonds? Did they just do this just to, you know, reference this song?
Yeah.
Or so, did they have a personal interest in Barry Bonds particularly?
So I think it was written around the time that Barry Bonds hit broke the all-time home run record. But then, they were kind of like, it was fresh in their mind. Hmm. And then just the theme of the song is, here's another hit, Barry Bonds. Like, Barry Bonds gets a bunch of, a bunch of home runs. So they were saying like, yeah, just comparing their hit record to a hit and a home run.
Gotcha.
Yeah. All right. Cool. So that's Barry Bonds. Let's go ahead and take a break real quick. I think this is the halfway point. We'll do this one. We'll do this last one, and then we'll take a break.
Drunk and hot chicks.
Drunk and hot girls. So we'll go ahead and roll into track number 8, Drunk and Hot Girls.
I know they know a lot about that.
This one is featuring Mos Def, also known as Yasiin Bey. Huh. This one's produced by Kanye West. And on this one, he explains his frustrations with extremely drunk but incredibly hot girls. Okay. Pretty straightforward.
Okay. It's not a good sight, that's for sure.
Yeah. All right, Drunken Hot Girls. Here we go. Mm.
We go through too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls. She go through too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls. We go
sucking on me, can't stop popping.
My shit
sucking on me, can't stop popping.
Mess with her. She go through too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls. Don't do too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls.
This is the kind of song when you hear it, it's one of those songs. You know how some songs stick in your head.
Just want you drunken hot girls. You wanna sit down, but we hit the drive-thru. You drunken hot girls.
He said, I sit down and eat with you.
Please don't fall asleep, baby. We almost back. Please don't throw up in the car. We almost crashed. Oh, now you sober. How'd I know you'd say that? You drunken hot girls.
shit just to mess with these drunken hot girls. Don't do too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls.
Yeah. It's the fun, sorry.
Dangerous necessity that people seek without regard to where they are. The human heart is curious.
That's nice.
Above all things, Lord, the lights are low. Your eyes are bright. The music plays its sweet delight.
Hello.
It's out of sight. I'm feeling right. Your dress is tight.
That's good. That's good.
I want you right now.
Don't tell
now.
Me you sing you
there
got
you
go.
To get a deal. You can't keep on
oh, you hear that?
Sound. You can't keep on
yeah. Oh.
Only live once, do whatever you like. I thought I'd be with you for only one night. Now I'm with this girl for the rest of my life. That drunken bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls.
A little sippy sippy.
We go through too much bullshit just to mess with these drunken hot girls.
She says you want a brewski?
We go
a little sippy sippy.
Bullshit to mess with these drunken.
Yeah. Ah, there you go. There you go again. Man.
All right. Damn. That is Drunken Hot Girls featuring Mos Def. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Okay. It's really what I thought about this song.
Yeah.
Okay. If you took all this music away and all this production away, and two guys were sitting around singing this song, you'd be like, listen to them singing that stupid song. You know, because they drunk. You know, they making this simple, you know, little stupid singing a stupid song.
Yeah.
And then he takes it and he. All this musical, and then you got Mos Def and the violins and the pianos and the big orchestra, and he turns that shit into a classic. a stupid little song like that, and it sounds classic. You know, it's like so good.
Yeah.
You know, that's the mindset of these guys I'm learning about, a lot of these rappers, mm-hmm. man, really.
Taking something so simple and...
And they make it... illuminated and just you're like damn. You know, so yeah, I like that song. I like the hook.
Yeah, I'm glad you like that song. So this is actually in the Kanye West trilogy, the College trilogy, people regard this as one of the worst songs.
Is that right?
In these three albums, which I always liked this song. Like growing up, I never really skipped this song. But like as like I got older and just started like reading through Reddit and the people's thoughts on this album and stuff, people always like call this out as like one of the worst songs on here.
No,
but
no.
I like it. I thought it was produced. It's silly. It's
I've heard idea. thousands of worse songs.
Yeah.
This song right here. I'm sure. Saying. I mean, and I'm not even like you know all into all the culture and stuff like that. And this song right here, like I said, it sounds like a like you and I was sitting somewhere on a beach or in a freaking sports bar. And
yeah.
We start singing this little stupid song. And the drunken girl, and all that, you know, drunken hot girl.
Yeah.
So, and then, for like I said, then he started adding all this extra.
Yeah, and I think it's produced very well.
And you hear that violin. Yeah. That violin was just talking to you.
Yeah, man. It's kind of like it almost sounds like some Arabian Nights. Yeah,
exactly.
Violins.
Exactly. Yeah, 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 that's what I was thinking too. Arabian Night kind of like sound. Yeah. Uh-huh. You hit the nail dead on the head when you said that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I always liked Mos Def's little bridge in there. I thought that was really pretty.
It's a fun song. Yeah, I wouldn't bag on that. You know.
Like, yeah. People really like. They're like, oh, Drunken Hot Girls is the worst song. They say that Graduation is the worst out of the three of the three albums. That's what the people say.
Uh-huh.
But I think they place a lot of that on Drunken Hot Girls.
And
but I don't know.
So Drunken Hot Girls is actually the song that drug the album down.
That's what people say.
Okay.
But I don't know. All right, we'll go ahead and take a break. All right, we'll go ahead and roll into the next track, which is my absolute favorite track from this album. This one is called Flashing Lights.
Your absolute favorite?
My absolute favorite.
I know it's got a good beat.
Oh, my God. I used to just play this song on repeat.
Is that right?
Oh, man.
Okay.
I think it's a lot of people's favorite song from this album. But, yeah, it's just so good. It's produced by Eric Hudson and Kanye West, and it's featuring vocals from Dwelle. Dwelle was like a neo-soul artist around this time. Yeah, man, I love this one. All right, Flashing Lights. Here we go.
Those violins again. Good.
She don't believe in shooting stars, but she believe in shoes and cars. Wood floors in the new apartment, coupe tour from the store's departments. You more like love to start shit. I'm more of the trips to Florida, order the hors d'oeuvres, views of the water, straight from a Pepsi. Damn, these niggas got me. I hate these niggas more than a Nazi.
As I recall, I know you love to show off. But I never thought that you would take it this far. What do I know?
Flashing lights.
What do I know?
Flashing lights.
I know it's been a while, sweetheart. We hardly talk. I was doing my thing. I know what was fair, baby, hey, baby, lately, you've been all on my brain. And if somebody would've told me a month ago, front and oh, yo, I wouldn't wanna know. If somebody would've told me a year ago, it'd go get this difficult. Feeling like Katrina with no FEMA, like Martin with no Gina. Like a flight with no visa, first class with the seat back, I still see ya. In my past, you on the other side of the glass of my memories museum. I'm just saying, hey Mona Lisa, come home. You know you can't roam
as
without
I
Caesar.
Recall, I know you love to show off.
All right, that is Flashing Lights featuring Dwelle. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
That's a good song. I see why that could be your favorite.
Word.
Here. It was a good song. And again, he's with those violins, man. I just love artists that use a lot of violins, man. It just adds richness to the song. So, yeah, it's a good song.
I love Flashing Lights. We'll go ahead and roll into track number 10. And this one is called Everything I Am, featuring DJ Premier. Produced by Kanye West. DJ Premier does the scratching on this one.
Oh, okay.
So I like this one too quite a bit. It's like one of those kind of just, you just kind of getting back to just the rapping.
Right.
Yeah. Because a lot of this stuff is just like all this big production and, you know, that stadium sound. But this one, he's just kind of going in there and getting it done with the rapping.
All right.
All right. Everything I Am featuring DJ Premier. Here we go.
Damn.
here we go again. Common passed on this beat, I made it to a jam. Now everything I'm not made me everything I am.
Common passed on this beat, mm-hmm. So he decided to use it.
Yeah.
Here we go again. People talking shit, but when the shit hit the fan, everything I'm not made me everything I am. I never be picture perfect Beyonce. Be light as Al, be your black ass Chauncey. Remember him from Black Street, he was black as the street was. I never be laid back as this beat was. I never could see why people would reach a fake ass facade that they couldn't keep up. You see how I creeped up? You see how I played a big role in Chicago like Queen Latifah? I never rock a mink coat in the wintertime like Killer Cam. I rock some mink boots in the summertime like Will.i.am. Let me know if you feel it, man. Cause everything I'm not made me ever tear it up. Haters, start your engines, I hear I'm gearing up. People talk so much shit about me at barbershops, they forget to get their hair cut. Okay, fair enough, the streets is flaying up. Cause they want gun talk or I don't wear enough. Baggy clothes, Reebokser, Adidos. Can I add that he do spaz out at his show? So say goodbye to the NAACP award. Goodbye to the NDRE award. They'd rather give me the nigga please award. But I just take the I got a lot of cheese
now,
award.
Now.
Damn. Here we go again.
You hear that?
But everything I'm not made me everything I am.
You didn't hear that?
Damn. Here we go again. Oh, yeah. People talk the shit, but when the shit hit the fan, everything I'm at made me everything I am. I know people wouldn't usually rap this, but I got the facts to back this. Just last year, Chicago had over 600 caskets. Man, killing some whack shit.
Boy.
Oh, I forgot, except for when niggas is rapping. Do you know what it feel like when people is passing? He got changed over his chains, a block off Ashland. I need to talk to somebody, pastor. The church want tired, so I can't afford to pay. Put slip on my door, cause I can't afford to stay. My 15 seconds up, but I got more to say. That's enough, Mr. West, please, no more today. Hey.
All right, that's Everything I Am featuring DJ Premier. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, Kanye is deep, bro.
Mm-hmm.
He's deep. I like everything about the song because of the lyrics, man. It's so true.
Mm-hmm.
Everything he's not made him everything he is.
Mm-hmm.
He is today, whatever. So he's like, man, it's so, I like that song. Now, to me, that one out of this album so far, and I know we got to finish the rest, but... one or two, that's my top one or two.
Okay.
For me.
All right.
You know, it just, for some reason, that just hits me home.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Just kind of embracing his flaws as the things that make him special.
Mm-hmm.
I love that song, too. What would be your other top two song?
Oh, man.
So far.
Oh, no. Let's see. I would say, get my glasses on first. Man, oh wow. I like Can't Tell Me Nothing.
Oh yeah.
Can't Tell Me Nothing.
Yeah.
And then I did enjoy Champion 2.
Mm-hmm.
Man, Good Life was good. Man, all of but if I had to if you say just one, I had to pick another choice, then it would be Can't Tell Me Nothing.
Can't Tell Me Nothing. Yeah. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's a good one. All right, we'll go ahead and roll on to the next track. It is track 11. This one's titled The Glory. This one is produced by Plain Pat, G. Robertson, and Kanye West. No feature artist on here. Just a cool little sample. All right, The Glory.
I'll take you to the glory. I can't stand it, no, yeah. Yeah. Now we're the South Side. Now we're the West Side. Yeah. Can I talk my shit again? Even if I don't hit again? Dog, are you fucking kidding? My hat, my shoes, my coat, Louis Vuitton.
time stitch with Donatella Versace, that's Louis Vuitton, bitch. I think Hennessy, I drink, I'm gone off that Bacardi, Limon, a Corona, I'm zoning. Class back in session, so I up to the grade. In 2 years, Dwayne Wayne became Dwayne Wade. And hey, please don't starve me, I'm like Nas Barkley, me Charles Barkley. I'm Pop the Barkers, I'm Hood the Parkers. While y'all was in limbo, I raised the bar up. I trust on everything, married to the game. Rock the chain instead of wedding ring. Y'all bridesmaids catch the garter. On nights when gay romance, cameras flash so much that I gotta do that yayo dance. I'm on a war tour with Common, my man. After each and every show, a couple dykes in the band. It's easy, the hood love to listen to Jeezy and Weezy. And oh yeah, Yeezy, I did it for the glory. But with my ego, I can stand there in a speedo and even that like a fucking hero. Yeah. The glory, the story, the chain, the polo, the night, the grind, the empty bottles of Nodos. Tank on empty, whipping my mama Bobo. I spent that gas money on clothes with logos. The fur is earned, yeah. Man, shit that you don't floss. The Goyard so hard, man, I'm Hugo's boss. Why I gotta ask what that two-do cost? House in the hill, two doors from Tracy Ross. And I'm asking about her girlfriends, yeah, the dark skinned one. She asking about the speedboat, so I admit we winning them. Now we're the west side.
All right, that is the glory. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I like that. I wish it would have went just a little bit longer. But again, back to these violins, man. He loves using them. And these played with you the whole time, just little hits. You just kept hit, zut, zut, zut. And, you know, it was like, and then they go, yeah. You know, and it was just like over and over through the whole track, man. It just made it just, it was like so much icing on that cake.
Yeah,
you know
yeah,
what
yeah.
I mean? It was nice. That yeah. was nice. I liked it.
Yeah, I like the glory. I don't know if it's like one of my favorite ones off of here.
But when you go back and listen to the instrumental, when you, the arrangement and stuff, when you start listening to it in detail, uh-huh. That's when it's going to get you. I'm telling you, listen to it that way.
I love the instrumentation on this for sure. I just, I don't know. I felt like his verses was just like, okay. There's good lines in here, mm-hmm. But I just feel like, up to this point, like every verse hits from Ye on these records.
But that one.
You think it
fell short?
I just felt like it fell short. Mm-hmm. Like it wasn't just like super fire all the way through, like pretty much all his other verses.
Right.
Up to this point. So okay. I don't know. That's right. That's me on that one.
All right, gotcha.
But yeah, I do like the instrumentation on that one. And of course the background vocals and the choir. It's like when you do all of that, it's like you could kind of like have a whack verse every once in a while. Because exactly. It still just sounds good to listen to.
Right.
So, all right, cool. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track, which is track number 12. This one's titled Homecoming.
Okay.
It's featuring Chris Martin from Coldplay. He's the lead singer from Coldplay. And it's produced by Warren Campbell and Kanye West.
All right.
So here's Homecoming. Here we go.
Yeah. And you say Shy City. Shy City. Shy City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now and then?
Yeah.
Do you think about me now and then? I'm coming home again.
I met this girl when I was 3 years old, and what I love most, she had so much soul. She said, excuse me, little homie, I know you don't know me, but my name is Wendy and I like to blow trees, and from that point I never blow her off. Niggas come from out of town, I like to show her off. They like to act tough, she like to tone them off and make them straighten up their hat, cause she know they soft. And when I grew up, she showed me how to go downtown. In the nighttime, my face lit up so astounding. I told her, and my heart is where she always be. She never mess with entertainers cause they always leave. Or to follow your dreams, sometimes I still talk to her, but when I talk to her, it always seems like she's talking
stopped.
About me. She
yeah.
said you left
it's
your kids
whole
and they just
yeah.
like you. They
it's
wanna bad. Rap and make yeah. soul beats just like you, but they just not you. And I just got through talking about what niggas trying to do, just not new. Now everybody got the game figured out all
wrong. I guess you never know what you got till it's gone. I guess that's why I'm here and I can't come back home. And guess when I heard that, when I was back home. Every interview I'm representing you, making you proud. Reach for the stars, so if you fall, you land on a cloud. Jump in the crowd, sparking lighters, wave them around. If you don't know by now, I'm talking about Chi-Town.
Do you think about me now and then? Do you think about me now and then? Cause I'm coming home again. Home again. Maybe we could start again.
All right, that is Homecoming featuring Chris Martin. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Dude, all I could say, Kanye is an entertaining genius. Because I'm gonna tell you something. When the song started, I was like, I don't like that.
Yeah.
And then when you start hearing him rap, I'm like, damn, you listen to what he's saying? And then that piano was constantly going, dun, 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 the whole time while he's talking through the whole song.
Mm-hmm.
That was like a marvelous display of, I don't know what it was, man. I just can't describe it. But that piano was, it was like the undertone of the whole thing. It was just like, that's what held it all together and made it sound so good. And then with his rapping and with his words, what he was saying, you know, what he was saying in the song.
Mm-hmm.
And I, like I said, I started out not liking it. I was like, damn, at the end, I was like, damn, that's nice. He makes you respect him.
Yeah.
It's almost like that's his goal, and everything that he does is I'm a demand my respect from you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way he comes at, to me, that's the attitude I get from him.
Yeah, in his music, yeah. Mm-hmm. What'd you think about the vocals on the hook from Chris Martin?
Nice. Yeah. Nice, yeah.
It sounded pretty good.
Yeah, I liked it.
Would you like to hear his voice anymore?
It would be nice because, you know, he was like, he's got a really kind of unique voice. It's smooth, but, you know, I would.
He's from a really big band. It's not really my, it's not exactly what I listen to, but I do like some of the songs that Coldplay has made. And I don't know, maybe, I don't know if our subscriber.
Is that a boys band or something?
It's like a rock band.
I've heard of Coldplay, but I don't know what genre of music.
Yeah, it's like rock, kind of pop-ish. I don't know. I don't know anything about Coldplay, so y'all tell me about Coldplay.
Okay, so Chris Martin, is he like one of the lead singers?
Yeah, he's the lead singer in the band.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but he's dope. I liked his feature on here, and I like a couple of Coldplay songs. So if you guys want to us to both react to Coldplay's album or something, drop a comment.
Okay.
But the story too. Did you pick up on kind of like he was comparing a woman to Chicago? Like,
no, I didn't.
Oh, okay.
Well, kind of. But the thing about it, it was so many things going on on the song. So to me, I'd have to hear this song like three times.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? And then I could pull it all together, but there was so much stuff going on in the song because I was so keyed in on the
instrumentation. Yeah, for sure.
So, and then he started rapping and I was just like, I would see certain parts of it. I'm like, oh yeah, that's good. But then I was back to the music. I'm listening to that.
Yeah.
And then I missed some of the,
you know what I mean? Yeah. Well, just to kind of, pointed out a little bit too. Yeah. He's basically, I met this girl when I was 3 years old. What I love most, she has so much soul, you know, and then he just talks about the weather there, but, you know, she used to blow trees. I never blow her off, you know what I mean? All that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm. I caught some of that.
But yeah, he gets into it and basically tells this love story about Chicago and, you know, how it's treated him and how it's, you know, formed him. And then he kind of does the reveal at the end. He says, if you don't know by now, I'm talking about Chi-Town. But, yeah, definitely check the song out again.
Yeah, I want to check it out.
Listen to just because when you put that with the piano and the Chris Martin and the everything else and the fact that he's just comparing Chicago.
No, I felt like I missed half of what was going on in this song, but I really enjoyed the song.
So. Right, cool. So. Well, hopefully you visit that again because I think you'll even enjoy it even more when you hear how he makes that comparison. It's really cool. All right, we'll go ahead and roll right into the next track. This track is 13. It's called Big Brother. Produced by DJ Toomp, and this song is basically Kanye's ups and downs with Jay-Z.
What?
And kind of just shouting Jay-Z out and telling kind of their relationship story.
Is this going to be negative? I guess I have to.
You're going to find out. Big Brother, track 13. Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Oh, well, he called it Big Brother.
Yeah.
Stadium status.
Stadium status.
My big brother was Big's brother. Used to be Dame and Big's brother. Who was hip-hop brother? Who was no ID friend? No ID my mentor. Now let the story begin.
Okay, and then also, this is like after the fall of Rockefeller. I think we kind of touched that
Bit. Okay, so when we touched on it, Rockefeller had not failed. It was about to fall.
Correct, or at least maybe it was...
Starting to...
A little bit starting. But it had just kind of happened, for all sure. Right. And so this has happened now. Rockefeller's okay. No more. They've kind of split. So Dame and Biggs and Jay-Z have all parted ways.
Okay.
And here he is. Here we go.
Cool.
Hard knock life to a sellout. Picture us in the mall, copping iceberg and yell out, Jigga. Yeah, that's a weird yell out, yell out. You know the name, do I gotta spell out or tell about J-A-Y and Ye's so shy that he won't even step to his idol to say hi. Standing there like a mime and let the chance pass by. Back of my mind, he could change your life. With all these beats I did, at least let him hear. At least you could brag to your friends back at the gig. But he got me out my mama crib. Then he helped me get my mama a crib. Big brother was Big's brother. Used to be Dame and Big's brother. Who was hip-hop brother? Who was no ID friend? No ID my mentor. Now let the story begin. Begin. Let the story begin. If you feel the way I feel, why don't you wave your hands? Fresh off the plane, I'm off the baseline. Nothing handed out, I'm about to take mine. Around the same time of that Blueprint 1. And these beats in my pocket was that Blueprint form. I play my little songs in that old back room. He'll bob his head and say, damn, oh, that's you. But by the Black album, I was blacking out. Party at SOBs and we had packed the crowd. Big Brother got a show up in Madison Square. Wow. And I'm like, yeah, we gon' be there. But not only did I not get a chance to spit it, Colleen told me I could buy 2 tickets. I guess Big Brother was thinking a little different and kept Little Brother at bay at a distance. But everything that I felt was more bogus, only made me more focused, only wrote more potent. Only thing I wanna know is why I get looked over. I guess I understand when I get more older. Big Brother saw me at the bottom of the totem. Now I'm on the top and everybody on the scrotum. My Big Brother was Big's brother. Used to be Dame and Big's brother. Who was hip-hop brother? Who was no ID friend? No ID my mentor. Now let the story begin. Begin. Uh-huh. Let the story begin.
Let the story begin. Yeah.
If you feel the way I feel, why won't you wave your hands?
Yeah.
Have you ever walked in the shadow of a giant? Not only your client, Presidito, Ola Ovito. The game getting fouled, so here's a free throw. I was always on the other side of the peephole. Then I dropped Jesus Walks, now I'm on a steeple. And we know New Jack City gotta keep my brother, but to be number one,
New Jack
I'ma
City
beat my brother
on
that remix. I swore I spazzed. Then my big brother came through and kicked my ass. Sibling rap, next thing I know, he got a song with Coldplay.
Oh, no, he did.
Back in my mind, I'm like, damn no way. Translate Espanol, no way, Jose. Then I went and told Jay Brown. Should've known that was gonna come back around. Should've talked to you like a man, should've told you first. But I told somebody else and that's what made shit worse. My big brother was Big's brother. So here's a few words from your kid, brother. If you admire somebody, you should go ahead and tell them. People never get the flowers while they can still smell them.
Oh, man.
That's
big
a good
brother.
Song. That's a good song. Okay.
You was feeling that one?
Yeah, that was a real good song.
Tight. Yeah. What'd you like about that song?
It was heartfelt, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could feel all the love, you know? The respect.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But he still put his little 2 cents in, like he always has to, which is legitimate to me.
Yeah.
You know? So, hey, that was a good song, though, Big Brother. Yeah, I like that one.
Awesome. What'd you think about the beat?
It was nice.
Yeah.
And it kind of just flowed and dun dun. Dun, dun.
Yeah.
And yeah, just all these little touches in it.
I was just like, dun, 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 dun.
Yeah, yeah.
Dun, 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 dun. That was just like, oh, so powerful.
It is.
Yeah.
It is.
DJ Toomp produced a lot of these real big stadium sounding songs on here. He had a hand in them. And DJ Toomp actually was working with T.I. at the time, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, really?
And Kanye had worked with T.I. and
okay.
got with Toomp and was like, oh, you do something really cool. And then he, you know, brought that to this album. So I don't think this album happens this way without DJ Toomp.
It cracked me up because he jabbed at Jay-Z and yeah. then he kind of took it back, kind of like, yeah. you know, because he's like, yeah, well, I guess I should have said something to you first before, you know, I said right, something to somebody else because he did something with Coldplay. Then Jay turned around and did something with Coldplay. And I guess Jay was like, And then he go, oh, man, I should have said that to you first.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, you thought I wasn't listening, right?
That's it, for sure. Yeah, definitely. I really like that song. And just like you said, just heartfelt. And you can just tell he really meant it, you know?
Right.
And he just feels like he really looked up to Jay-Z and still looks up to him. And,
yeah. You know. But, you know, that was cold on when he said that Jay-Z was at the Madison Square. And he thought he was all up in there with them, and then they wanted to sell him a ticket if he wanted to go. That was cold.
That's cold.
That was cold, man. I don't know. That would have been a hard one to swallow and forgive, man. He's got big patience.
Yeah, for sure. That just gave him more.
Like, cold. All right. Dude.
That gave him more reason to succeed. Like,
yeah.
Nah, I'm going to show him. Uh-huh. I need to be in here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And eventually, what's really dope in the story of Kanye and Jay is they eventually do The Throne.
Right.
They do Watch the Throne, which is a collaboration album between Jay-Z and Kanye West.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Is it good?
It's so tight.
Really?
Oh. You never heard of Niggas in Paris? Oh, The Throne.
That sounds like
sick.
That's a good song. You know, are they talking about those two?
They are the niggas in Paris. Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. And you know, they splurging, they flashing, they doing it all, man. They just having the time of their life. I can only imagine what the song is and how they describe two niggas in Paris.
Niggas in Paris is like one of the hardest rap songs of all time, for
really?
Sure.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, they have a really cool, I don't know. Just
see, that's going to take everything. If you ever plan on springing that on me, that's going to take everything in me to not try to not listen to that song now.
I know, because it's the name of it, right? All right, bet. We're going to listen to Niggas in Paris. We're not going to listen to, we're not going to do the, we'll watch the video.
Oh,
we'll react to the Niggas in Paris video.
Oh, they got a video too.
Yeah, yeah. They're gonna love that.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna love it, I think.
All right, so for our patrons, we appreciate you so much. We're gonna right after this, we're gonna react to Niggas in Paris video, and we're gonna put it on Patreon just for our friends of the show and our family members on Patreon. They're gonna get that reaction first. So subscribe, please. We appreciate your support.
Okay.
All right. Bittersweet Poetry featuring John Mayer. Have you ever heard of John Mayer?
That name sounds familiar. Yeah. No, I was going to say something else, but no. Okay. I've heard that name before, though.
Yeah, he's like a guitar player and a singer.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of seems more pop stuff. I feel like Kanye was definitely getting in his pop bag on this one. Like,
okay,
he definitely, like, last album he had, like, you know, Paul Wall and Cameron and like all these rappers, right? Mm-hmm. But like on this one, I feel like it was less. Oh shoot, he had Nas on the last one, Jay-Z. Mm-hmm. On this one, it was more about getting these pop singers on the hooks, like mm-hmm. Daft Punk, John Mayer, Chris Martin. It feels like he was making a conscious attempt to cross over to a different
audience. Right. Smart.
Very smart. And also still keeping the integrity of his music, because it didn't sound like he was like not being Kanye. It sounded like a natural progression of
just switching it up.
Yeah.
Just switching it up.
Just making it bigger fresh. And yeah, for sure.
Yeah, that's what 50 told him.
Go ahead, switch the style up.
Switch your style up,
and
bro.
If they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up.
Pile it.
For sure. All right, here's Bittersweet Poetry.
Yeah.
You never heard this bad, never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been gently warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency. And she claims she only with me for the currency. You cut me deep, bitch. Cut me like surgery. And I was too proud to admit that it was hurting me. I never do that to you. I'm one of them bad nights. You have a bad fight. And you talking about a family.
Yeah, like a gazoo type.
Maybe even a motherfucker, your mama's a bitch. You know, domestic drama and shit.
Damn.
All the attitude. I never hit a girl, but I shake the shit out of you.
Damn.
I'm gonna be the bigger man. Big pimpin' like Jigga Man. Oh, I guess I figure it's
sweet.
Yeah.
You're gonna be the death of me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.
Damn.
This is what I want so much. Should never hurt this bad. Never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been gently warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now.
Need you. You at the very same time, bittersweet. You're gonna be the death for me. I don't want you, but I need you.
Yeah.
I love you, I hate you at the
feeling
very
that song.
Same time.
See what I want so much. She never hurt this bad. Never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been gently warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency. See what I want so much. She never hurt this bad. Never did this before. That's what the virgin says. We've been gently warned. That's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now. This is an emergency.
Sweet. You're gonna be for me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.
Yeah. I love that. I love that. Yeah. I like that song, man. I was feeling all of that.
Awesome.
Yeah,
awesome.
That harmonies, man. That was a nice song. And then, yeah.
That was I believe that's John Mayer on the guitar there, as well as John Mayer singing the hook there as well. So
yeah.
Both of those favorite parts John Mayer supplied for you.
Was he talking about Kim on this song?
No, this was before Kim.
Before Kim.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. He wasn't with Tim. With
Kim. With Kim, yeah. Kim. Yeah. I think around this time he's with Amber Rose.
Oh.
He made her pretty popular.
Oh, yeah. I remember her.
Yeah. She's the bald one.
I thought she had short blonde hair.
Yeah. Pretty much. Yeah. Like a buzz cut.
Right, mm-hmm. Right.
That's her. Yeah, so he actually is going to end up breaking up with her, and then that's when he produces My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. One of the greatest albums of all time.
That's the name of the next album following this album?
Yes.
You better be careful.
I'm pretty sure that was the next one. Maybe not. Maybe it was 808s. It might have been 808s and Heartbreaks first, and then this. But I don't know. The commenters will let me know, because I'm not going to look it up right now. But anyway, all right, we'll go ahead and move into the next track, which is titled Good Night. So Bittersweet, you was feeling that one, yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Cool.
We'll burn that today.
We gotta get your Bluetooth working.
I've been waiting.
All right, Good Night is the last track on here. Okay. This one is featuring Mos Def and I'll Be Back.
I'll Be Back. All right, that's a new one, definitely.
Yeah, I actually don't remember this song.
You know?
Yeah, no.
It must have not been, I don't know.
I don't remember it. It says it was a bonus track on iTunes and certain international versions.
Japanese and British. And
yeah. So, okay. I don't know.
Australian.
Here we go.
They know it then.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah, so I'm sure the subscribers know because they're listening from other places. Okay, Good Night. Here we go.
I'm not sure anymore, more. Who is knocking at my door, door? All the faces that I know, jam at them so sunny and
I don't wanna say goodbye to you. So I'll just say goodnight to you. My people, no goodbyes to you. I'm just gonna say goodnight.
Right now, I can see it so vivid, like it was just yesterday, like I could relive it. Me and my grandparents on a field trip, and I'm the little kid trying to touch the exhibits, but it a faithful I get to get a hold of that. Man, I wish I could stop time like a photograph. Every joke that they told, I know to laugh. Man, I wouldn't let a moment pass.
Not sure anymore and more. Always knocking at my door. All the faces that I know, jam at them so sunny and true. I'm not sure anymore and more. Always knocking at my door. All the faces that I know, jam at them so sunny and true. I'm not sure anymore and more. Always knocking at my door. All the faces that I know, jam at them so sunny and true. I'm not sure anymore and more. Always knocking at my door. All the faces that I know, jam at them so sunny and true.
All right, that is Good Night, track number 15 on Graduation for somebody in some country. I've never heard that song until today. What do you think about that one, Dad?
I like the song. And again, that's another one. This is the second one on this album where I thought I wasn't going to like it when it first started out.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you get into the beat and the song and what it's about, pardon me, I liked it. It was a really good song. I really liked it. I heard some, it sounded like somebody was playing a cello. Sound like pianos. You got, and that bass line was nice.
Mm-hmm.
Everything, man, about this song, the melodies, the Mos Def. You know, these are true artists, man.
Mm-hmm.
True artists. You know, I'm starting to admit it. You know, that these guys really were talented.
Yeah, for sure. You
know? Okay.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Would you say you're a rap fan yet?
I ain't going to say I'm all the way in yet. Cause some of it, okay, put it like this. You've been giving me the primo.
Mm-hmm.
Of the cream, you know, the cream of the crop stuff.
For sure.
And then I think there's a whole bunch of them out there. They want to be big, but they just kind of like, to me, kind of still raunchy. And, you know, they just want to use a whole lot of hardcore language and stuff like that. And I don't, you know, there's some messaging in that too. I mean, I'm sure it is. But these guys are doing it in a way, even though, you know, it's adult language, but it's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
the music.
The music, yeah. And the way they collaborate with one another, and what's interesting to me, and I think that is one of the that has to be a talent in itself. You know, a lot of the good ones, the great ones, like your Jay-Z and your Nas and your Kanye's, the people that they bring in to do productions with them and collaborate with them and stuff like that, man. You got to be thinking, you know, when you're trying to put an album together, you got to be thinking, man, okay, I want to do this song with who I want to do it with, how I want to do it, you know, and man, that takes a lot of thought and homework.
For sure.
You know?
Yeah.
I respect that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
These guys work hard.
Definitely. I think that's a huge part of hip hop is like the collaborating.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, there's like a lot of debates, but I think like when it comes down to it, like making the best product, you know, is like the most important thing when you're an artist, you know. So if you can collaborate with people and take something up a notch and up a level, like,
you know what? I was just thinking just now, and I didn't want to lose. I didn't want to lose my train of thought. Okay, Kanye really has an advantage.
Why is that?
Because he was the beats guy,
right?
So everybody wants his damn beats. Now he take my own damn beats and put it on my stuff,
right?
You know, so to me that's an advantage right there.
Yeah.
You know, because he ain't had to go to nobody for beats, and I'm pretty sure he probably does occasionally. You know, kind of like your boy Fitty told him, switch it up, up. He probably gets some beats from somebody else, but most of them are probably his, because he, in his mind, the way I see Kanye, my beats are better than everybody's anyway. So I don't need to get them from somebody else.
And I think this is kind of around the time too where he would like start working with a producer and get their beat, but then like make their beat
his beat. Own.
He add his strings to it or add his drum to it or whatever, you know. So and then and we'll see that as we get further into Kanye's discography.
That's his ego, man. Cause look, he gonna get a beat from somebody else, and he's thinking in his mind, well, if that was my beat,
this is what I would do.
And then he handles it. He handles it, man.
That's exactly what he does. That's exactly what he does. That's cool. All right. Yeah. So that's Graduation. What did you think about the album as a whole? What did you think about it? Maybe compared to the other two Kanye albums that we listened to. What are your thoughts?
Honestly, this album right here, it was a really good. I think the whole body of work was really, really good. It was entertaining. It was thought provoking. Sometimes it was heartfelt. It was a whole lot of emotions in this album. Which from the three albums that I've heard now from Kanye, that's what he does. He's thought provoking. He tugs at the heartstring. He's serious about everything he does. And if I was going to compare all three albums, you can't, to me, in my opinion right now, what I've heard, I can't say that one is better than the other, because each one was individually good in its own right. So, I mean, they were all three good in their own right. So I can't say one's better than the other, because I like them all equally. They really are good pieces of work.
Yeah.
So.
All right. Cool. So that is Graduation, guys. The full uncut version is going to be available on Patreon. And then shortly after, we're going to get the YouTube version uploaded. Please consider subscribing to our Patreon if you'd like more exclusive content and you'd like to support this channel. Other than that, that's all I got. Dad, anything else?
Hey, I'm waiting to see the video now.
Yeah.
I'm excited about that.
Yeah, we're going to do that right now. All right. Thank you so much for watching our channel, guys. Please give this video a big thumbs up. Drop a comment what we should listen to next. And also turn on your notification bell so you can be notified every time we drop a new video. Thank you so much, Gap Gang. See you later.